Sean Harper. They'll be countered by the dynamic trio that Winthrop presents, Keon Johnson, Keon Moore, and Andre Smith. The front court guys aren't slouches either. This is the only meeting of the season between Charleston Southern and Winthrop, the new unbalanced schedule in the Big South. Denies us a second meeting between these two, so bragging rights on the line tonight. And Charleston Southern looking to win at the Coliseum for the first time in 13 years. It'll be the Eagles basketball as we get underway. An excellent officiating crew, Ted Valentine, Anthony Jordan, and Tim Nestor. And the first possession turnover for Winthrop.
Andre Smith just couldn't catch Johnson's pass. If you're used to a 55-52 game, you're in for a surprise tonight. They're going to get up and down the floor. They're going to shoot threes, and transition is going to be really important for both teams. Both teams play man-to-man more than zone. That's the way they both started.
In order to get all those points, we're going to need to catch the ball on the perimeter, though. That's step one. Arlon Harper, entry feed is a giveaway, and Xavier Cooks, the talented freshman from Australia, with a theft. Smith attacks the rack, stick back, rounded in for Tevin Prescott.
Offensive rebounds.
Eagles coming off a 6-point loss to Radford this past Saturday. Charleston Southern won at Liberty by 12. Buccaneers only turned it over 5 times on Saturday, and nearly a second giveaway in the opening minutes here. Off the deflection, it's Wheeler to Nimley, rises for 3. He was 0-for-8 from deep 2 days ago. 1-for-1 tonight.
We talk with him at the shooter round. If a shooter gets going early, look out.
Andre Smith, the quick answer. The shot clock was at about 31 when Smith scored. And now quickly, it's Bowen, the response for the Bucks.
So Bowen does not get you a lot of points. Anything he gets is a bonus, only averaging 8 a game.
Xavier Cooks attacks Gomware for 2.
Cooks, a kid from Australia, freshman, very, very active, very athletic, and plays with a little bit of reckless abandon to go along with the haircut. I love him.
Reminds some of Anderson Varejao out there with his size and athleticism, not to mention the flowing locks. Gomware cross lane, Harper.
Winthrop got caught staring at the basketball. Gomware made a nice move, but a great cut by Arlon Harper for an easy one.
Prescott gives us our 6th lead change in the first 2.5 minutes.
The offense has been good, the defense has not. For that man's team, they have to stop the basketball and transition. Winthrop wants to shove it down your throat. And then, as we talked about in the open, offensive rebounds are really important. They're really good at it, they need to continue to do it. It's all about effort.
There's Barclay Redabaugh, the 10th year head coach of CSU. As Prescott completes the 3-point play, the foul was on Gomware. Well, after both teams turned it over on the first trip, we've got some pretty good pace, and now Nimley gives it away. Smith, the interception.
There's stop the ball. They did it. They're trying to get him in transition. That's what I like about Cooks. He's aggressive every time he touches the ball. He's going to make mistakes. He's a freshman, but he's aggressive.
Eagles off to a good start. What are their keys tonight?
Well, when you look at Coach Kelsey's team, you have to watch number one Sanders. Everybody knows about Harper and Nindley, but Sanders, Will Sanders will burn you. And push with vision, Keon to Keon. The two Johnsons are very, very good in transition. You got to look for each other when you're getting down the floor.
Gomware just picked up his 2nd foul, so he was replaced by Will Saunders. Nimley had his pocket picked from behind. Cooks hits Moore. That's pretty.
Inside out's the way to make threes. Mr. Cooks is turning this game around just because of effort plays.
Relentless energy for the 6'8 kid from New South Wales. Harper off the back bracket. Moore the rebound.
You can see Arlon Harper picks up the ball half court. That slows them down a little bit.
Keon Johnson rims it out, but Prescott again on the offensive glass.
Will Saunders had the ball in his hand, and Prescott just took it away from him. Coach Kelsey all day in shoot-around was energy, energy, energy. That's the way they're playing this beginning 3-4 minutes.
Eagles have scored 8 in a row, and Prescott has 7 points already. And they haven't run a play for him yet.
No, that's the way you get the easy ones.
Wheeler spinning and scoring.
Nice play. Cooks might have rolled over that right ankle a little bit. He grabbed it. We can see him flexing a little bit coming up the floor. Hopefully he just slipped and didn't hurt himself.
Substitutions for both teams headed to the scorer's table.
There's going to be some subs. There's some pretty good pace working here on both ends.
Smith rising fire. In and out, and Bowen secures the rebound. Prescott lurking nearby again.
Well, if you're Charleston Southern and you're getting a defensive board, you better secure the basketball, because Prescott's going to take it away from you. There's Will Saunders.
Offensive rebound, Wheeler. Resets for Harper.
Extra possession.
Saunders a second try this trip. Still comes up empty.
Guys in the blue shirts are not shy about shooting the basketball.
Saunders, great hustle on the floor, keeps it alive.
Everybody looks a little tired. That's why there's a bunch of subs ready to come in.
Nimley, and it's a blocking foul against Prescott. Really increased off to a great start today, and this guy has had some just unbelievable performances over the past month. Saad Nimley, the only player in America to score 30 points 4 consecutive games this season.
And to add to that, his assist to turnover ratio is better than 2-1. He's got 93 assists and only 43 turnovers. So he's responsible for so many more points than he scores, and he really scores a lot of points.
And to add to that, he's usually the shortest guy on the floor, but maybe not tonight. Wheeler the steal, comes up short, but an offensive rebound for Danny Upchurch. Off the bench, the Connecticut native. Upchurch, cross lane pass deflected and stolen.
That's a good idea, too.
Keon Moore, that's his range.
Wheeler dared him to shoot it, and he shot it. All right, you just learned something, young man. Do not dare him to shoot the ball. Get in his face, run him off that line.
Keon Moore, one of 3 guys in this game who are in the top 20 in the country in 3-pointers made per game. Along with Nimley and Saunders, and here's Saad Nimley off the mark that time. Derrick Henry the rebound. And look at the pace that Winthrop tries to create.
Well, it's all about if Smith gets it, if Keon Johnson gets it, they're going to just fly down the floor. And look at this guy. This is a work in progress.
Dubio KK, the physical specimen. A nice move for the freshman.
First to seventh with a subpar weekend. That man was upset with his basketball team, and deservedly so. We'll see how they react to his encouragement.
Wheeler attacks over OKK for 2.
Wheeler made a couple bonehead plays defensively, but he just made up for one of them. Now he's got to continue to play at this end. Got a tough cover. Having to cover Keon Moore.
Moore slashing. Pinballs right to OKK, off the window.
OKK's learning to do what he does best around the basket. He makes his first 2 shots. That's got to help the young man's confidence. Redshirt freshman.
6'8", 230 pounds of muscle. Defense a work in progress for OKK, and he gives the foul as Javis Howard, a promising freshman for Barclay Radebaugh, has a chance for a 3-point play.
It's really nice play by Howard to use his momentum against the defender, and the rim is a screen. Howard's gonna go for a and one opportunity. You know, you always talk about Saad Nimley, Arlon Harper, Will Saunders. Coach Radebaugh's got some freshmen that are producing for his basketball team and giving him a little depth and giving him a little production as well, as we saw right there with the 3-point play.
Oftentimes, freshmen are better at one end of the floor than the other. And as a coach, you sort of have to massage their minutes to get the most out of them without giving up too much.
And build them up without breaking them. You saw Coach Radebaugh getting everybody's face in that timeout. I think he should have done that.
Andre Smith creating for Keon Johnson. And Winthrop gets another possession. The key that Nate Ross talked about off the top. And Okeke fouled by Bowen this time. Second chance points are big, so are points off turnovers. Winthrop has an 8-1 lead in that category so far.
To try to keep Okeke from going where he wants to is a tall task for anybody. But you know, going back to the point you talked about, in high school, everybody's a great offensive player. Not many teams play defense in high school. And you're probably the best player on your team. You get to college, different story. You got to play D because everybody's on scholarship and everybody's pretty talented. That's the end that the freshmen have a tough time dealing with.
Davenport, the whirling shot won't go. Saunders the rebound.
Saunders a lot better offensive player. That's pretty good defense.
Arlon Harper sets up Saunders. His three is off the mark. Rebound deflects for Okeke as Smith took a hard hit. But he's back up on his feet and joins the crew. Johnson to the wide open man. Henry can't stick the three. Winthrop started 8-for-11. The Eagles cooling off a little, one for their last five. And Harper rims in and out the three. Bowen stick back, won't go, but it's a second foul on Dubie Okeke.
Cedric Bowen, little teams have as many offensive as defensive rebounds. That's impressive.
It is early. Bowen 64% from the stripe this year. Barclay Radebaugh, Pat Kelsey, two sideline commanders for this one. Bowen known more for his game-winning dunks, the heroic jams to beat Ole Miss and to beat Campbell this season.
Cedric Bowen, big-time athlete, another long athlete. There's a lot of them on both of these teams this evening.
Prescott back into the game with one foul. Spinning and scoring over Bowen.
Nice play because they tried to dig it out from the guard to knock it loose, and he just kept his composure in the post.
Prescott already's got 9. Bowen retaliates.
Cedric Bowen, a little offensive game. He's not known for that. Guess he figures he has a mismatch. Let's take advantage.
Johnson, the slippery guard. Back outside, and the three on the way, in and out for Henry. Cooks can't save it as he tumbles into the cheerleaders.
And then apologizes. But if Charleston Southern get points out of Cedric Bowen, 8, 10, 12 points a game, that's a huge asset for this basketball team. They're going to get it from the backcourt. They get it from the front court, that's a plus.
You could say the same thing about Winthrop,
true,
though, couldn't you?
That's true. It's a guard-dominated league, there's no question about it. The best players are the guards, except for one player, Mr. Brown at High Point.
Upchurch on the drive, can't finish. And Ted Valentine says Winthrop ball. Big game for John Brown and High Point tomorrow as the Panthers look for revenge against the Radford team that beat them in a tight one at the Dedman Center in Virginia a couple weeks ago.
Yeah, they're one of the, as you talked about in the opening, unbalanced schedule, that is, they play each other twice. Wesley Johnson's in now, a freshman, to give Bowen a break. We'll see if he can play like Bowen did on the glass.
And Saunders defending Prescott. Basketball swings for Moore. Back to his fellow Keon Johnson for Prescott. Finally missed a shot. Saunders almost traveled on the rebound.
Yeah, it looked like he, a little pirouette, almost lost his balance.
Midway through this first half.
You get a shot from up top right there, you see it. Both teams great spacing offensively because of the ability of the backcourt to drive. You gotta give them an opportunity. With the spacing like this, they have it.
Saunders had a tough catch. Three rims out, Buccaneers now 1 of 8 from deep, but inside it's the freshman Johnson who tees up the second chance, and it's going the other way.
Wesley Johnson did his job on the first rebound. Big kid at 6'8", 230, and I think he committed that foul. No, excuse me, that foul was on Will Saunders. If you're watching at home, you're saying, boy, Charleston Southern shoots threes. You think coach will rein him in a little bit? We asked him that today. He looked at us like, no, I'm not going to rein him in. That's what we do. That's what Arlon Harper and Son Emily does for us.
He said there's one game when we're 5 for 25, not going well, but then you make three in a row late. Big contact, Smith and Nimley, no whistle, and Moore reins in another triple.
Yeah, Moore's got some deep range with that three ball, and he showed it to everybody right there.
His third three of the half. He averages about three per game, 18th in the nation.
Best thing I thought, we talked to Coach Kelsey about him and how good he is and how good he can be. He said, Nate, he's a great kid. That's the best part about it. He's a better person. He's a basketball player. Pretty good basketball player.
Transfer from Catawba College. He had 22 points on Saturday. His ninth 20-plus game of the season, albeit in the loss to Radford. So Winthrop trying to bounce back from that Saturday loss. And Andre Smith draws the foul into the paint. It's on Danny Upchurch. Joey Lopez, a freshman for Winthrop, into the game for the first time as Gomwer and Bowen both return. Gomwer playing with the two personal fouls for the Bucks.
Playing really well, too. Bowen playing a little better. Coach rolling the dice a little bit. Gomwer's got two.
Lopez gets his first touch. He doesn't shoot it often, but he usually makes it. Moore from a deep, deep range. Finally missed it, and it'll be Buccaneer ball.
I thought Lopez might go after Gomwer simply because he had the two fouls, but he didn't. Charleston Southern, we talked about the offensive boards. They take a lot of threes, long shots, long rebounds. They've not gotten a lot of them yet. In the last couple minutes, early in the basketball game, they did. Somebody's got to get hot. Good news is so many guys shoot it that they have the opportunity for different guys to move. Look at this move.
And Nimley runs in a contact, goes tumbling into the dance team.
Nice catch by Anthony Jordan of Son Emily. Now, he's a remarkable story. Barkley Radebaugh, in the beginning of the season, calls him a miracle simply because the doctors told him 50-50 shot, you might never play basketball again.
He hurt his knee last year. They thought he might need microfracture surgery. That's what the first doctor said. What'd he do? He got another doctor. He got a second opinion.
Second opinion, please.
Someone said that he might be able to play again. And you talked to him today. Not quite 100%, and here's the turnover. Andre Smith, one on two, and he scores. He was ahead of the pack, and Winthrop now leads by 10.
And we got a chance to talk to Son, and I told him, I said, are you back to 100%? He said, no, but I'm learning to deal with it. I said, what about the 430-plus games? He said, I was just shooting it real well. There's another chance.
That shot is his comfort zone, but Bucks now 1 of 11 from 3.
Said he's learning how to deal with it.
Andre Smith off the bracket. Gomwer the rebound.
Big time board by Gomwer.
He gobbled it up. Nimley into the paint.
Guy of that size goes inside with the big guys. He's got a lot of strength. Nice timing there and finished it. I saw a layup go in. You never know what that does for the threes. Makes him confident.
Crafty feed from Lopez. Cooks wasn't ready for it, though. And it leads to a turnover.
Nimley knocked it loose and grabbed it. He just made his last basket. See if he goes up again.
No-look feed for Gomwer.
That's not Paul Gomwer's shot.
Deep into this first half, really the shot clock has not been a factor at all either way. And it won't be here as Upchurch unleashes the three. Gomwer in the offensive glass. Inside, Wheeler fakes it, takes it, and makes it.
Good job by Wheeler to shot fake first, get people up in the air, and then finish it. Another offensive board for the Bucks gives him another opportunity.
Deion Moore, the pull-up rattles home.
He got knocked down, too. He's looking at Tim Nestor like, how about a call?
Deion Moore into double figures for the 16th consecutive game. That's the longest active streak in the Big South. He's got 11 in the first half.
Can you see, both teams look very tired to me. I don't know if it's just me, but they just look winded.
Well, a couple factors might be brewing into that, I used to call it. And then Keon Moore caught fire in the second half. Winthrop took High Point to double overtime.
If Coach Kelsey, if you have a conversation with him for more than 10 seconds, Coach Prosser's name will come up. And all in very, very positive light. He thought very highly of the man, worked for him. Skip Prosser, good man.
Traveling violation. Teddy Valentine all over. Saw nimbly pivot foot that was dragged on the floor.
Coach Prosser left us way too soon, but his son is an assistant coach at Coach Kelsey and left a lot of coaches with a lot of great thoughts about him. Man, we just talked about Keon Moore's not in the game, so this is a chance. He's getting a rest, but it's a chance for the Bucks to make a couple stops without the prolific scorer in there.
Andre Smith crossover for three.
That's a great crossover to get separation from the defense. And another senior, Andre Smith, pays it off.
That's not a move that a coach really teaches a player, is it?
No. He learns that when he's 10 years old.
He's got a quick look at Mark Prosser, Skip's son, who was an assistant at Bucknell and now an assistant under Pat Kelsey, who played for Skip Prosser at Xavier.
There he is.
There's Mark Prosser. Looks a little bit like his dad.
Yep. We saw an aberration right there. We saw Harper and Nimley not on the same page. That rarely happens.
Legal screen will nullify this Smith triple.
I believe it was Lopez. Winthrop comes off a lot of screens, some ball screens, some off the ball screens. You've got to be stationary. They're such good shooters. Give them a chance to catch and shoot.
Pat Kelsey's first coaching job was as a freshman basketball coach, Elder High School. Guy who was one of the stars on the Davidson team that went deep in the tournament, Thomas Sander, was on that high school team. And from there, he worked a few years. Was in the running to become a director of operations at Xavier when that job came into existence. Skip interviewed two people, Chris Mack, who's now the head coach there, and Pat Kelsey. And he gave the job to Chris Mack. And Skip Prosser told Pat Kelsey, don't let me ever tell you no again. And Pat Kelsey has really devoted himself to his craft. He became a director of operations at Wake Forest under Skip Prosser. And an assistant coach as well. Here's Harper, finger roll to the basket.
Well, transition for the Bucks. Yeah, the good thing about the way Charleston Southern plays, and they're shooting it really poorly from deep, they can get them in bunches. They can come back from deficits.
The day that Skip Prosser got the Wake Forest job, he called Pat Kelsey, and Coach Kelsey said, Coach, I'll be there tomorrow. And he drove through. He didn't know anything about Winston-Salem, except for the fact that he had one AAU tournament as a player. He played against Allen Iverson, and Pat Kelsey tells it he held him to 34.
Not bad. Pretty good job.
Prescott. Nope. Oh, what a defensive play by Prescott intercepting the outlet. Johnson inside for Lopez.
Let me tell you something. That's a phenomenal play by Prescott. He misses the shot, doesn't pout, steals the ball, and sets up Lopez for a two. That's nice. That's effort.
Joey Lopez doesn't shoot it very often. In conference games, he's now 14 of 17 from the floor.
That works for any coach. That gets you more PT right there.
Saunders, he's been cold.
Saunders will let it fly every time he touches it. He's got great form, he just can't make one.
He's 0 for 6 from the floor, 5 of those from beyond the arc. Eagles have matched their largest lead, looking to add to it. Johnson, gone with the rebound. Nimley throws it away again. This is like an instant replay from before. Andre Smith coast to coast.
Andre Smith read that pass absolutely because they know they're going to make threes. If you talk about it, that just puts another seed in the kid's head. I think it's the defense. We got to stop them at the other end, guys. We'll score our points. We got to stop them at the other end.
Nimley 2 for 4 so far, now 3 for 5.
Nice call from the bench to set up Sonnemli off a, it's not a staggered screen, it's more a screen one way, screen the other way, but eventually the defense made a mistake and Nimley got an open jumper. This is the end. They have to string 2-3 stops together. Not a lot of time left in this half to do it, but to finish the half that way would be a big plus going in the locker room. What a move.
Johnson right past Nimley, and he draws the bumping foul on Saunders. That was a great flare screen.
He's amazed that that young man is playing this year because of the injury we referenced earlier. And Sa Nimley's, yeah, I'm really happy for Sa. I told him, I said, I'm so happy because he was so bummed last year in the tournament. He got hurt late in the season. He was operated on April Fool's Day, he told me. April 1st, I said, Sa, you know, that's April Fool's Day. He started laughing. But he's back. He's as close to 100% as I've seen him. And I was just happy for a kid. It's another great kid to be back playing college basketball for his senior season.
Two free throws for Keon Johnson. Eagles extend the lead out to 13.
Same play they scored with last time from Nimley. He's got a mismatch. He can go by this young man.
Oh, Cook's got the ball. Nimley threw it off the backboard.
Going to get Prescott underneath Bowen, I believe. So I was just throwing it up there because he thought he was getting a foul call. He never got the whistle, but the Bucks did.
So that's the second foul on Tevin Prescott. So now Prescott and Okeke, each with two first half fouls for Winthrop. That Cooks played pretty good defense there on the blur that is Sa Nimley.
Oh, no question. And he knew it was coming because Nimley saw the big guy on him and figured, I'm taking him. Didn't foul him, made him throw up a crazy shot. But this young man on the free throw line got the offensive board.
One and one. Bowen front rims it.
Little things. Johnson does a great job of sealing out the shooter. You see so many times guys forget to seal him out, comes right back to the shooter.
Andre Smith has had a good first half, 9 points, four rebounds. Illegal screen, Lopez.
Second one on him. Both of his fouls are illegal screens. He's just not set. You want to get there as a big so quick so you can set the screen up for your guard. But if you do it illegally, it doesn't do any good. You turn it over.
Final minute of the first half. Lopez playing with two. Short jumper. Saunders has had a first half to forget.
Yeah, that was a little deep for Saunders, I think. The other shots have been really good ones.
Cooks through the double team for Smith. Got it.
Easiest three to make is when it comes from the inside. The defense is contracted. They just can't get there as fast as the ball does.
Largest lead of the half for Winthrop. Here at home, the Eagles lead by 16. Charleston Southern looking for the final shot. Can't get all the way down to zero, though.
A drive and an and one would be a great way to finish the half for the Bucks. Winthrop with a chance to stop them.
Oh, and Nimley lost it. Lopez outlet for Smith. Ahead for Johnson to the basket. No! Harper. Oh, the shot clock buzzer sounded with a couple.
Interesting. Plenty of time for this young man right here.
Nimley, good if it goes. Nope.
Good shot.
About as good as you could hope for.
Yeah, absolutely.
Comments he made about the Newtown shootings after their game at Ohio State. Little over a year ago. He's got three kids now, two young daughters and a little boy.
I saw Coach Raderball first. I really think the first couple minutes are important just to see how hard his kids are going to compete.
Cooks with a fine outlet pass for Johnson. And this is Smith, who's wide open. Got it.
Raderball smiled on the sidelines. They just lost Smith in transition.
Do you draw any conclusions from these 35 seconds, Nate?
Not yet, but I'll tell you in another 35 or 40. There's certain guys you can't lose.
Wheeler spinning to the basket.
Pretty good move, but Smith's one of them in transition. The two Johnsons and Smith, you cannot lose in transition. Those are the three predominant downtown shooters. One possession is not going to make a basketball game, so we'll see if they can improve. It's about effort when you're down like this. It's not about execution as much as it's about effort.
Keon Moore couldn't finish with a left hand, and could not control the rebound, even though he initially had it in his grasp.
Pretty good defense by Aaron Wheeler not to foul him, because that was the whirling dervish of Keon Moore there. That's one stop in a row. All you want to do is get one in a row. Suddenly saving time, and we have 18:46 to go in the first half. Cut hard, screen hard, do all the little things to try to do something to get back in this baby.
Gomwer from the wing, short, Cooks another rebound. What are you seeing from Winthrop defensively in terms of how they're bottling up Son Imlay?
Well, their pack line defense is what they do. What that means is play the ball as hard as you can play, and everybody else is one step inside the three-point line. As Coach Kelsey told us today, when somebody drives, everybody's got to suck into that lane and make them shoot over us. When they're shooting the percentage they're shooting, it's working really well. They start making threes, doesn't look as good.
That pack line defense has been just about perfected by that Virginia team.
Coach Bennett's been unbelievable at it. Held the Tar Heels at home to 64. They dropped to number 3 in the rankings. That's not going to last for long.
Fans are furious for the ruling that this is Buccaneer ball.
But it's all about guard your yard is one of the terms I looked at. In other words, when it's within your 3-foot area, guard it hard. After that, when somebody drives by you, hopefully some of your 4 teammates will help. But it's protect the paint. Don't give up easy ones.
No foul on the Gomwer Cooks contact. And instead it goes against Keon Moore, or is it Tevin Prescott? They got Moore, and that's just his first.
Coach Bennett's dad is the one that kind of got it all started. It's a sagging man-to-man, it's a helping man-to-man. Pack line is just the term of the season or last couple seasons. Everybody's got to be connected. That's the tough part on defense. You got to be connected to your teammate to help. Duke's really good at it, too. They just don't call it that.
Gomwer's first 2 points of the day. Buccaneers back within 15 after the Smith three brought it to 19. Good position inside for Prescott. Left hand short. Gomwer the board.
Good post D and better rebound. Now, all that's good, but you got to turn it into points. Got to execute.
Arlon Harper's been pretty quiet, trying to find his offense. Fortunate to sustain possession.
Pretty good effort by Harper. Thought he got fouled, just hung in there.
And it'll be Winthrop ball. Moving screen on Gomwer. That's his third personal.
Trying to free up a teammate. The third one's a tough one. Anthony Jordan, he's talking to Anthony Jordan. Anthony Jordan said, you moved. Got to call it.
11 turnovers now for Charleston Southern. You know, in the first 10 Big South games, they had single-digit turnovers in 7 of them. A lot of time left in this one. Cooks aggressive, but unsuccessfully maneuvering to the basket.
11's not terrible, but 10 in the first half is.
They're not going to win too many games with 10 turnovers and a half.
No way. And then shooting what you shot from deep.
Imlay, his foot was on the line, but the shot was no good anyway.
Stop the rock in transition.
And Winthrop gets it from one baseline to the other in a hurry.
Coach Kelsey told us, if they don't stop a transition, we're in great shape. If they do, we got to score in half court. That's the guy that can do it. He's so composed. He's so skilled. He's not a good shooter. He's a maker. There's a big difference.
He's a pretty good shooter, too. 42% from three this year. He's got 15 points in the game. Nimley exploded to the goal, denied by Prescott.
Perfect example. The pack line D beat his man, but everybody else was there to help him. Nice
extra pass. Johnson in and out. Cooks went down hard on the rebounding action to the other end. This is Wheeler again attacking for two.
Well, you know, Coach Raderball said, if we got an open three, fine. But how about we attack the glass a little bit? I'm sure he talked about that at halftime. That young man just did it exceptionally well.
A little bit of a turnaround there. If Johnson makes that three, it's a 20-point game. Instead, Buccaneers get two at the other end. And Wheeler bumps into Keon Moore.
It's about advantage, disadvantage. Wheeler bumped in the first time. Foes got him.
Eagles with the ball. Smith, Moore, Henry, Cooks, and Okeke. The big man Okeke has played limited minutes because he got two quick fouls in the first half. Only 3 minutes in the first half for Okeke. Moore lets it go. Oh, he almost put it in.
If that one goes in, your coach right about you, sit down on the bench and say it's not our night. I mean, that's, you just got to resign yourself to that fact. Didn't go in, they're okay.
Henry nearly knocked it away.
He didn't know he did either. He hit the ball, he didn't get the turnover, but he didn't even know he hit the ball.
Another deflection, this time it was Moore, poked it away, Wheeler recovered. Saunders draws the foul. That's what he needs to do. The outside shots aren't falling for him tonight. He's 0 for 6 from 3, so why not attack the rack?
And when you drive a couple times, the defense will back off. You might get a 16-footer, and then an 18-footer, and then you get behind the line. But Will Saunders, the senior out of London, England, transfer out of Central Florida, good move.
Charleston Southern for the season has shot 45%, 35% from 3. The three-point disparity tonight has been significant.
You saw what Saunders clap his hands. He saw the ball go through the basket. He hadn't seen that many times tonight. That's a plus.
Saunders, the British basketball player, grew up in London, went to the College of Central Florida with Alhaji Fulla, who was on the Buccaneers the last couple of years with Saunders.
I think that's the first two he's seen go through.
Henry from the corner, and he got fouled. Upchurch, a little too aggressive. Three free throws coming up for Derrick Henry.
Well, Upchurch got stuck on the screens inside, and the closeout was completely out of control, and he fouled a shooter, the Cardinal sin of basketball. Never, ever, ever foul a jump shooter.
Winthrop, 3 for 3 from the line tonight. Still perfect as Henry drains the first. Missed all of last year recovering from the ACL surgery. A couple years ago, Derrick Henry was the leading scorer on the Eagles.
Gotta love the kicks too. It's not quite Winthrop maroon, but I like him.
Probably a Think Pink night that necessitated.
Absolutely.
The Derrick Henry sneakers that he's sporting. Still perfect from the charity stripe. Eagles now 6 of 6.
Not easy to do to make 3 in a row. In practice, you normally make 2 and rotate. It's pretty good making all 3. Winthrop lighting it up from the line and from behind the deep line. Attack the basket. There you go.
Saunders getting back to the line.
Oh.
Oh, and our camera guy just took a spill, but Derrick Henry and Josh Davenport graciously help him up. That's Tim over there.
Tim, take him on for the team. Watch this right into your living room. Hold on, Tim. Good job.
Nice job, Tim.
He's fine. The chair has wheels. That was a plus.
Free throw rims out for Saunders.
The tough part that Coach Radebaugh is thinking about is, do I want to press a little bit? This is a dangerous team to press.
Yes.
Because of that man with the ball, because of Keon Johnson, they'll just blow by you. So you got to be judicious in when you press, if you press.
Okay, K, a good position. Can't flick it in, though. Saunders the rebound. He stole it away from his teammate, Paul Gallmer.
Good job surrounding big man Okay, K, inside and make him miss. Now you got to score.
Wheeler always looking to drive. Saunders lost it. Moore, the deflection and the steal. And Tim Nestor.
Smith turned his ankle.
Yeah, official timeout.
He's running right down to the end of the bench to Jeff Lahr, the trainer. The trainer says, come with me. Instead of, are you okay? Just come with me. It's going to be a retape job, we would think. Came off on his own power, as we saw. Jeff will take care of him.
Well, Prescott screens Henry. Tough shot and the foul. It might be Winthrop's night.
Tough is an understatement. This is a remarkable shot. Derrick Henry gets his head and shoulders past the defender, gets popped, has to come back to his right hand, and banks it in. That's a heck of a shot for an and-one opportunity. That's special. See, great concentration. He kept his eyes on the rim. I always tell young kids, when you shoot a bow and arrow, you don't look at the whole target, you look at the bullseye. When you're shooting a basketball, don't look up, look at a spot on the rim. That's exactly what he did, and he made it.
Three fouls now on Upchurch. 6 points now for Henry on the second half. Wheeler defended well by OKK. Three on one the other way. Johnson for Henry. In the foul once more.
OKK.
The owners of their largest lead in any Big South game all season.
Well, he just walked up to the bench and gave Coach Kelsey the nod, like, I'm good. Put me back in, Coach.
Blocking foul. Derrick Henry charged with it, but what a half Henry's had. He got the three free throws when he was fouled on the three, and he's had 2 3-point plays.
Yeah, Charleston Southern, it's all about effort and determination right now. Forget the scoreboard, because there's a lot more basketball games to play. This one's not over by any stretch.
Oh, Harper swatted by Henry. Davenport jockeying up the floor, and Gommer stripped him from behind.
Good job by Paul Gommer from behind to make something happen, not give up on a play.
Saunders finally finds the range.
Made a couple free throws. Felt a little better about himself. Every shot looks the same. He just hadn't made any till then. He's a good three-point shooter, but the Bucks won in the first half, and that's the second one for the evening.
We know this Buccaneer team can strike quickly offensively. CSU had 58 points in its first half at home against Gardner-Webb recently.
That's a pretty good move by OKK to square up, face the defense, and make an offensive move. We saw him out here early today working with assistant coach Marty McGillen. Marty a long time. He came over, we were talking, he goes, he's going to be good, it's just going to take a while. Redshirt freshman, big guys just take a little longer to get it, but he's got the physical skills, the physical body to be a phenomenal post player in this league. He's got the work ethic too.
Good to see Smith back in the game. Oh, nifty crossover for Prescott. And now Smith keeps the dribble alive. Under 12 minutes we go. Johnson. And Saunders the rebound.
That's good defense by the Bucks. To score at the other end, got the stop. Now, just basket by basket, try to cut into this thing.
Wheeler needs help. Nimley for three. That rims out. OKK tracks it down off the bounce.
Cedric Bowen just couldn't run around him to get the ball. OKK's so big, he physically couldn't get around him.
Would you want to try to run around those arms?
Heck no.
OKK lost it though. Buccaneers do their best work in transition, and it's a blocking foul.
You're a young person. Did you see what Son Nimley did right there? The minute
after he won the postseason Conference Player of the Year award as a redshirt sophomore last season.
Of course, for Scott Cherry at High Point University, there's Nimley with a nice little jumper on the inbounds play. That all was because Nimley got fouled, and it wasn't a shooting foul, so they got the ball out of bounds in that previous play.
Nimley now double figures in 14 straight games. That's the second longest streak in the Big South to this guy, Keon Moore. Smooth touch Tevin Prescott.
Had a really good start of the game and then kind of disappeared a little bit. This little pick and pop.
11 for Prescott. Lead back up to 18.
See the Buccaneers so much more aggressive defensively. That's a really smart play by Simon.
A couple times a night, he gets that call.
Great shot fake, got the defender in the air, number five, faked out number five, and Johnson fouled.
Coaches of other teams tell their guys, look, he's gonna try that move, and he still gets away with it a couple times a night.
Well, I really think in the heat of the game, kids just forget. I mean, he gets a couple threes, he drives by you a couple times, I gotta stop. And when he shot fakes, Keon Johnson went for it, finally kind of dipped into him. He's gonna get his third opportunity at the line here.
Very good free throw shooter, and he gets to the line a ton. Made over 100 free throws on the season.
Fearless is a good way to describe him, because he doesn't get fouled many times shooting a three like that. When he gets fouled, when he takes it in to the traffic with the big guys. But fearless is a great way to describe him.
One of the most amazing things about Son Emily is 2 years ago when Charleston Southern won the regular season title, the team's leading rebounder in conference games was Son Emily, who's listed at 5'8 and isn't anywhere close to 5'8 in reality. And the blocking foul called on the Bucks.
Tough kid. Charleston Southern University community really got behind him when he got hurt, supported him, and they love him. He's an ambassador for the program. He's going to be gone, and he's going to be missed by Coach Radebaugh and everybody in that university next year. But he wants to go on with a bang this year.
Foul was called on Saunders. It was his third. Prescott will shoot 1-1 midway through the second half. Oh, Xavier Cooks doing work on the glass for the Eagles.
That is not supposed to happen. Aaron Wheeler had the inside position. Cooks had a little more stick-to-itiveness. Slapped it around, got it, got fouled.
And that's the fourth foul on Saunders. So he'll go to the bench, Gomer back in. That was the first free throw missed of the night for the Eagles, but it didn't turn out too badly because Cooks right back at the line, and this will be another 1-1.
This kid's gonna be good. First time in this country, he went to visit another university, and then second time came down here and liked Winthrop, signed with Winthrop, only a freshman. He's got all the skills to be really good. He's gotta get over the culture shock of being in a different country. It's tough to do.
Grew up about an hour and a half south of Sydney, Australia, right along the southeastern coast in New South Wales. Emily short from deep. And here comes Keon Moore. Into the fourth quarter of this game. Foul on Wheeler. The ninth Buccaneer foul of the half.
Now you see Son Emily missed that shot. Remember, this young man had 4 30-plus games back to back to back to back a week and a half ago. So he's capable of big night scoring the rock. And yeah, I think he had 26 game after that. Yeah, he did. He had 26 after those 4 30-pluses in a row. But he can score. He's not having a good night tonight, neither is the rest of his basketball team from deep.
And yet, it's only a 16-point game. Andre Smith has been right in Nimley's pocket.
That's a tough cover, but he drew him tonight.
Stays with him through the Gomwer screen. Paul Gomwer for three, nope.
It was a nice little two-man game with Nimley and Gomwer. He just couldn't pay it off at the three.
Andre Smith, long. Cooks attacks the glass and kicks it out. The folks here in Rock Hill are gonna love watching this kid grab rebounds. Xavier Cooks hasn't scored a lot over the past month, There's a lot of little things to help this team win. And Keon Moore, 3+1. 3+1. You didn't really need an abacus to do that math, did you?
And I did not use the calculator on my phone. I did it all in my head. Now, if you would have given me the percentage, I would have really been impressed. And you're thinking about it now. I wouldn't ask you to do that. You'd probably get it right, but I wouldn't ask you. Anyway, a pretty cool 4-point play.
Eagles back up by 20. Emily tries to shake Johnson. He was 0 for 8 for 3 on Saturday. Saad Nimli is 1 of 8 from 3 tonight.
Keon Johnson is not stopping him, but he's sure making it difficult. He's contesting every shot. He's making him work for every shot. Take a little bit out of your legs if you make him work that hard.
8 minutes to go. Moore fakes the handoff.
Pretty smart play.
Tough shot. He got it.
Are you kidding me? That's a shot they're going to pay you to make next year overseas somewhere. That was a heck of a play.
19 points now for Moore. He's 7 of 11 from the field, and Charleston Southern is crumbling right now.
KK knocked it loose.
Henry, that could be the dagger. Although perhaps that Keon Moore shot was the dagger before the Henry drive.
That was pretty special. You can see at the top of the bench, the assistant coach calling the offense there. That's B.J. Mackey, the all-time leading scorer at the University of South Carolina. A great asset to Barkley Radebaugh and his staff. Really good relationship with he and the guards, especially Saad Nimli.
Seems like everything's gone right for the Eagles lately.
Since about 8 o'clock tonight.
OKK, call for the charge. So Doobie OKK picks up his third. Radford tomorrow and Coastal Carolina on Friday night.
And you saw top 7, 2-4 losses. That's not many, obviously, with a long way to go. It's all about seeding now as we get ready in a couple 5 weeks to get to Myrtle Beach.
Will Saunders, they ran a good play for him, and he buried the open jumper. That's the third Buccaneer three-pointer of the night, 3 for 23.
4 fouls on Saunders, but you got to have his offense. The coach has him in there.
Great. Lopez, Davenport, Johnson, Prescott, and Smith.
Great spacing all night long for Winthrop, which is giving them the opportunity for good shots.
Prescott triple teamed. Strong with the ball.
Dribbling away from Saunders, went after it, not a bad
and
move.
Andre Smith cashes in.
I think the ankle's okay.
The knee too.
Let's give credit to Jeff Lawler. I don't know what he did, but he fixed him.
Timeout called by Barkley Radebaugh with 5:40 to go. Winthrop.
BMI really gets up and down the floor.
Duger Bach and one of Barkley Radebaugh's best friends in the coaching business. Barkley Radebaugh spent a couple of years coaching here at Winthrop.
Yes, he did.
Early 2000s, won a couple of Big South titles as an assistant under Greg Marshall. They still talk often. But as coach of the Buccaneers, the Winthrop Coliseum has been a house of horrors. Tonight, barring a miracle comeback, the Buccaneers are going to lose their 14th game in a row in this building.
It's a long stretch.
Last win, February of 2002. That was when the Patriots won their first Super Bowl.
Oh,
in fact,
geez.
That was
enough already with the Super Bowl.
13 years ago tomorrow.
Okay, I'm going to stop. Enjoy your win.
Here's Davenport from the wing. 3 more for the Eagles, who have opened up a 27-point lead.
Talked about Coach Radebaugh getting ready for the next one. The guy on the other side of bench, Coach Kelce, just wants to keep it going because his guys are playing. Whoa,
Nimley again will shoot three.
But he gets up healthy. Coach Pat Kelsey wants to continue this. They are playing very, very well. He talked to us about transition. And his concern was, if we can't get him in transition, can we get him in the half court, the points? The answer is yes.
Saw Nimley 4 of 5 from the line tonight. And he'll shoot three here. Well, from Winthrop's perspective, a win tonight will move him to 7-4. Eagles are hosting the last place Liberty Flames on Wednesday, completing a crazy stretch, 3 games in 5 days. And then the Eagles have a whole week off before going to High Point a week from Wednesday, February the 11th.
Well, the way they're playing tonight, I don't care who's coming into this building, they're gonna be tough to beat. They get a couple in a row, once again, confidence going on the road, tough place to play in the Mill Center, of course, against John Brown and the High Point Panthers. But confidence is the biggie, there's a schedule.
The Eagles certainly think they have some unfinished business against High Point, who they lost to in double overtime about a month ago here in Rock Hill.
Good effort by Keon Moore, but by rule, when you go from the ground to the floor, that's a travel. And Ted Valentine is explaining the rules, and Coach Kelsey doesn't like it, but that's the rule.
You're up by 25, Coach. Take a breath.
No, with his intensity, are you kidding?
Saunders cuts into 22.
A couple shots for Will Saunders late helps his confidence.
Snaps a couple-minute field goal drought for the Bucks.
Boy, Cooks really moves well without the ball. Had a backdoor cut, they didn't see him.
Saunders can score quickly, can he? He's all of a sudden made 3 threes in a row. Lopez again inside.
Job for the lefty off the little dish inside. Yesterday was National Lefties Day, in case you didn't know it. Just figured I'd tell you that.
Well, today's Groundhog Day.
That's exactly right. And he saw a shadow, went back, so we got 6 more weeks of the cold stuff, but not in this part of the world.
You're gonna count the basket?
Punxsutawney Phil saw
steals that Winthrop has grabbed tonight. Charleston Southern turned it over 10 times in the first half, 14 turnovers in the game. Yeah. While Saad Nimley has 15 points, he has no rebounds, no assists, and 6 giveaways.
And he's a big-time assist man to go with his points. Offensive rebounding is a mentality, but when you're so aggressive doing it early, if you don't do it early, and then you continue to miss shots as a team, it's tough to turn it back on. And the Buccaneers kind of fell into that tonight.
Smith, baseline to baseline for Henry, and now Johnson. Smith for Henry, shot clock at 5. Smith, that's an air ball. Just grazed the bottom of the net. Looked pretty though in the air.
Yeah, the line was good. The distance was a little off.
Saunders has found the range in the second half, but his streak of 3 in a row comes to an end.
I like the way Winthrop, and they worked on this in practice today at shoot around. Drive and kick, drive and rotate. Keep the ball moving to get an open shot or to get a driving lane when the defense is late coming out. Spacing's all part of that as well. You can see from this shot up top, great spacing.
Nice wraparound pass. Lopez finally missed one. And the rebound pinballs for Nimley.
Nice little freshman-to-freshman move there.
Saunders lost it. The Bucks will keep it with 2:23 to go. From Winthrop's perspective, a year ago the Eagles were 11-10 and then won 9 of their final 12 games, including a run in the Big South tournament all the way to the finals. Do you think this Eagles team is capable of a run like that this year in February?
I do, because Cooks is getting better every game. Keon Johnson and Keon Moore obviously are very, very good players. I think that it's possible. And this young man, Henry's had a heck of a game tonight.
Henry, the layup. He's got 13 points and he had none at halftime.
And he will take a lot of grief in the locker room afterwards. His feet kind of messed him up for a possible dunk. He's going to catch it from his teammates on that one. I think they are capable. This is the one bid league. There's not going to be multiple bids from this league, in my opinion. So you got to get hot at the end of February, continue it to go down to Myrtle Beach and win three games in 3 days.
Coastal Carolina has the advantage of playing at home in the conference tournament once again. Harper, cross lane pass off the hands of Wesley Johnson.
No question they have the advantage in their building, sleep in their beds, and won it last year. The tournament, not the regular season.
16 turnovers now for Barclay Redabaugh's team. And Pat Kelsey is emptying the bench. Yeah, Hunter Sadlin into the game. Mitch Hill into the game. Also, Kellen Blake getting his first minutes in the conference season. Freddie Poole as well.
The intensity for Coach Kelsey has not dropped one iota from the 8 o'clock tip we had this evening. That's the way he coaches. You play to the personality of your coach. That's the way they play tonight.
Poole threw it outside. Pat Kelsey was the closest Eagle in the vicinity.
Look at those eyes. Look at that glare.
And I'll tell you, he could shoot it in his playing days. He could really shoot it. He was repeatedly named his team's most inspirational player. He was never the best guy, but he was the most inspirational guy.
He moved pretty good in practice. And what did he do in practice on a loose ball?
He went diving on the floor before anybody else did.
Gotta love that. Yes, he did. You gotta love to play for a guy like that. Yeah, coach is diving on the floor. Why can't I? Or he would say, I'm diving on the floor, why can't you?
Charleston Southern got a win at Liberty despite shooting poorly from three. Buccaneers gonna lose tonight despite that Harper layup. Buccaneers road trip continues. They're off on Wednesday, but Friday night, the Bucs have to go to Radford.
Tough place to play.
Radford's won seven in a row. Go for eight straight tomorrow night at High Point. Another tough place to win for a visiting team.
This league is a tough league to win on the road. It really is. Some good teams, some good home court advantages. You know, it might have been a little fool's gold when the Bucks won at Liberty, not shooting it well, thinking, maybe we can do that again. Well, not the case tonight.
In the last two road games, tonight, Saturday, saw Nimley 1 of 16 from three. Shot clock is off. And the Eagles can dribble out the clock.
Really good performance by the Eagles. Great transition game. Pretty good defense on the shooters for Charleston Southern. And they get a W at home.